And the heart and soul of these cars. Let's talk a little bit about the engine.
It's a 4-liter flat six, 9,000 RPM. We upped the power by 15 horsepower over the GT3, so it has 525 horsepower. By using hotter cams with longer duration, so the car makes more power at high RPM operation, has different cylinder heads for more lubrication in super high G situations, which that car really produces. We changed the cooling system a little bit.
I get excited when you talk about cam tweaking, more cooling. GT3 RS and PDK, they go together.
Absolutely. RS means range sport, means using the car on the track, trying to get the best performance out of the car on the clock as well. So you need a 7-speed PDK. It shifts faster, it is quicker, and it is easier to operate, yeah, to get the best lap times out of the car. And it's the perfect fit for that kind of car and for that engine. A lot of speculation was going on. What kind of engine would be in this car? It's a 4-liter flat six, six-cylinder engine, normally aspirated. It has 525 horsepower, so that's 15 more than on a GT3. How did we do that? Different camshafts, different setup, and the camshaft has higher overlap, creating more ferocity in the revving up dynamics, more power at high RPMs, which is a 9,000 RPM red line. And mated to this fire-breathing engine is a PDK gearbox, quite typical for an RS variant because it's really quicker on the track. And this gearbox has a shorter final drive if you compare it to the GT3's unit to compensate the bigger wheels.